Hey guys, I thought I'd show you what I'm working on, just to give you a hint before I paint it, in case there's any inquiring minds of how I went about doing it. I'm not doing a tutorial of how I did it, but I'll show you the parts and stuff. In this project that I've done, and thank you so much Templars Crusade 01 for holding that contest. That's awesome, and apparently you're sending me some prizes, so I'll have to do an unboxing and a thank you to whoever donated them. So anyhow, thanks so much. This got second place in his contest. So there was some custom work with the base, obviously, and also adding the fist, but other than that, these were really just paint jobs. You know, this is the model from the Dead Space Marine pack, and here's the other one, other than adding the bullets. Some guys thought that these should be brass, and I still might paint them brass because I'm tending to agree with them. However, I have two more objectives I need to make, and for this project to be done, I want 5 objectives, unless if 6th edition changes the objective rules, which I'm going to be pissed right off. But I thought I'd show you what I'm up to. I thought I'd first off make my own Dead Space Marine. So he's going to be lying something like so. So I've got one arm down and the other one in behind him. I'm not even sure what sprue these legs are from, but they're pretty cool pose. And then what I've done is I've taken an old metal apothecary. And for you guys that recognize this figure, this arm is actually fixed. In fact, let me see if I can find one. Exactly this figure, but it was a pose similar to this, where the arm was fixed right to the body, but there was a little bit more of a gap between his hand and his leg. But nevertheless, this was a ton of work extracting just the torso from that metal figure and also cutting the arm so that I could repose the arm. So I essentially drilled the metal legs out of it and then just started cutting and filing and chipping away. These are not lead, so they were a pain in the rear. And I cut his head off and drilled it out for a new head, so I'm not sure even which sprue you get these kneeling legs from. So this is what it's going to sort of look like. Just like that. I've got to dig into his chest because the scenario or the scene is going to be the apothecary is going to be removing the gene seed. So I've got a Crimson Fist head will be on the apothecary. Yeah, probably won't stay right now. I also have a Crimson Fist shoulder that will go on the other side. Here's his backpack. Now this I've not really done with any of my Space Marine stuff or 40K stuff, but I'm gonna add object source lighting to his flashlight on his backpack. And I've got to twist it so it lines up once it's all complete, but I want object source lighting going over his hand and then over the spot in the chest where he's cutting. So wherever he's going to be cutting should be lit right up. So I'm hoping that turns out. I've only done one other object source lighting, and that's been for the wizard that I gave Jedi Jim. The other arm that I'm going to put, and this was off, I think, some form of Imperial missile. And I don't even know which arm this was from. But this I'm going to act as though it's the vessel that's going to carry the gene seed. So it's going to be on the other arm posed, I think it's across his chest. Like so. Something like that, before it all falls. And then lastly, oh, yeah, that's right. This is going to be the victim's head, a Crimson Fist. And I'll have to turn his head so that it implies that he's dead. Get that into focus. So that's what this one's going to be. This has been a ton of work so far, let alone I'm not even done with the mock-up because I still got to cut open his chest and make sure everything lines up. That's where we're at with that. A few other things. I did it. I had to go out and buy a bomber model. Just extremely cool. Some guys might think that it's not very cool, but ever since I've seen Forge World had their fighter-bombers or shooters or whatever the hell they call them, I've wanted to paint it, but I didn't want to paint it because it didn't apply to the 40K game. So I was really stoked when they're putting this in the game. So this is coming soon as well. I do want to show you a blunder of mine that I thought was going to be cool and it just didn't work out. It was real difficult to do. I was doing a tutorial on how to cut. I know these aren't the flaps. The flaps are on the wings, but whatever the hell these are called on an airplane. I wanted them to be able to tilt when it's flying. Not that it's flying, but for posing. And I had pins in, but it was so tight to drill that out and get some form of hinge in there that I ended up gluing. Now you might look at it right now that it looks pretty rough, but once it's painted in the orc style, and that's why I wasn't afraid to trying it, is because I knew that at best I could just glue it back in there, green stuff it, but I actually like the spaces in between. Because once it's painted, especially in the orc style, that's going to blend right in. No worries. So that's coming. And then this one piece of sprue with five pieces caused my heart to skip. This brought me back to my childhood memories of putting together airplanes. And no matter what I did, I always got some glue on a piece of the clear plastic and ruined it. So this has caused heart palpitations as soon as I saw this. So I know I will be watching some of the guys that do models instead of 40K models. And one of the most popular, or certainly one of the most entertaining that I've watched, has been Damn Cranky's videos. So I'm going to be watching to see if there's any tips and tricks, especially in the 40K pictures. They have the supports in between the glass painted. So, yeah, I'm not too sure about this. And lastly, what do I do with all these paints? I'm at a dilemma here. For the place that I go, I think they charge $3.49 for GW paints. And here's one of the new GW paints here. The benefit of the GW paints for me is it's convenient, it's right down the road for me, it's cheap. If I run out of a paint, I can just run down and get it. But I also, another benefit is I paint straight from the pot. I know it's not the best way to go, but that's just how I've done it, and I find it efficient that way, and I know it's a little bit of waste of paint, but that's what I'm used to. So it's going to be a huge jump if I go to a Vallejo product. The problem is I want to jump in deep. So I'm either going to switch all my paints to the new line of GW paints, or the entire line of Vallejo paints, or Reaper paints. I have no idea what I'm going to do yet. The problem with Vallejo paints specifically for me is I don't really have a resource close to me that I could, if I ran out of paint, that I could just run over and get one. With the exception of ordering through eBay or online, but then you're into shipping costs and also shipping time. That being said, no matter what, I think it's going to be like a $450 at least investment to get the full line of paints. Either Vallejo or, like, the Vallejo model color, or whatever that's called, the basic line. And I would also like the model air. That's one reason why I'm tending towards going towards Vallejo, is because of the model air. Because putting GW paints through your airbrush can be done. I've done it, but it's a pain in the ass. So I'm tending towards Vallejo. But then it's the convenience of having GW stuff close to my door at a reasonable cost. Any input into this dilemma, please let me know. It'd be nice if be nice if I just could finally make a decision and find somebody to buy these from, because I think I'd want to buy the entire set of Vallejo line products. Hey guys, you might have remembered like 6 or 7 months ago when I was collecting the D&D miniatures, and now I'm playing the Legend of Driss board game, and it's getting closer and closer to being able to have a game at home. And part of this is this collecting of these miniatures. So you can see that I've got spots here that I'm still missing on these miniatures. And I've got tons of, well, I shouldn't say tons, but I know I've got some 40K stuff that I could trade for D&D miniatures if anybody has them. I know I accepted some Reaper miniatures. One is from Nurgle's Nastiest. I think he was the latest. And I can't remember who else, so I apologize for Hilo's Painting, I think, sent me some D&D stuff. But anyhow, if you guys have any of these miniatures around, because sometimes I've heard that guys would have like 30 or 40 of them, and then that's about it. So I am interested in trading for these, or just outright buying them if you have them. And even considering Reaper stuff if you want to get rid of it, because I had a lot of fun painting this little dude. I've got a lot more, but they're really cool miniatures. So yeah, if anybody's got anything that like D&D minis, the originals, and I'd need the cards. So if you have the cards, I'd need the cards, because I want them together. And or Reaper minis. So cheers, and just send me a PM on YouTube, guys, and we'll see if we can strike a deal. I'll see what I've got in 40K, or just send you some cash. Thanks. Bye-bye.